Joining me on India Today is Arif Mohammed Khan, Governor of Kerala and a respected scholar of Islam. Sir, welcome on India Today.
Thank you very much.
Sir, is hijab intrinsic to Islam?
You know, it's not a question of my opinion or your opinion. Islam has itself spelled out clearly what is intrinsic, what is essential, and in the Islamic language they have been described as five arkan, of five pillars of the faith. That is what is essential, what is intrinsic, what is integral to the practice of the religion. The five pillars are, first, the attestation, which is called Kalma-e-Shahadat, that you believe in one God, you believe in the prophethood of Huzur Sallam. Then is the Salat, that is the five time prayers. Then is the Zakat, that is the
donations,
alms, which you give out of your income. Then is, after Zakat is Hajj, which is not obligatory for everybody, it is obligatory only for those who have the means available with them. So if you want my personal opinion does not matter. Islam itself says that there are only five things which are intrinsic, which are integral for the practice of the religion.
Fair enough. What do you then make of these six girl students of a women's pre-university college insisting on hijab in the classroom, which the management says is in violation of the uniform code?
No, the basic question which comes to my mind, I ask myself whether at the time when they applied for admission into the college and they signed the form, was this dress code, the regulation was in force or not? So they did it knowingly and they have signed signed on the documents. If this is something which has been introduced after they were admitted into the college, then I can understand their, if they feel that it is necessary, then they can raise the question. But if this dress code was in place, the regulation was in place at the time when they took the admission, then they are only violating, by demanding something new, they are only violating the civil contract which they had agreed to and they had duly signed it with the college.
Okay. Of course, the management says that in the previous years, and they've put out pictures to buttress their point, these six girls or the 90 other Muslims or the 600 other girls, nobody wore a hijab or nobody had a different dress code. They all wore the same uniform. But the protests in Karnataka, the protests in Maharashtra, other parts of the country, Governor, if I may, is this misinformation or deliberate politics? There is no ban on hijab. There is a uniform code in place in these educational institutions, sir.
Exactly. And I ask myself this question, that if we accept this argument, because you started the question with whether it is intrinsic, whether it is essential for the practice of the religion, for argument's sake, except that it is intrinsic, it is integral, then what is going to happen to the Muslim women who are serving in our security forces, who are serving in our police force? And now it is not only the security forces, and even engineers, even doctors, and not only these areas. Now the in defense sector, Navy, Air Force, our Army, they have opened their door to women.
Yes.
So If you accept this argument, then I ask, the question which comes to my mind is that if you accept their argument, then are these women going to sacrifice their career? Or they are going to live with a guilt feeling that because of our service, we are not able to practice something which is essential and which is intrinsic to our religion? You are going to create confusion in their mind. Whose interest are you going to serve? You want to drive away Muslim women from the mainstream?